just to be on record, I enjoy my vegetables, and plants need CO2. So I want to make sure we still have plenty of CO2 out there so we have green grass and green vegetables growing, because we need CO2. We can't eliminate all CO2. So I think we're going to have an interesting debate for those that want to produce something that's actually needed by our environment, just claiming that they're improving the environment. Representative Dush.
Thank you, Chairman, and it's actually a nice segue. It's kind of interesting. I worked as a state park ranger up at Elk, Bendigo, and Kinzu Bridge State Parks. The town of Instanter was buried under that lake when the east branch of the Clarion River Lake was done. Clarion River just won River of the Year because of the clean water, the kayaking, the angling, and yet that was a tannery that is buried underneath that river. We've done a great job through industry and the people who have reduced the carbon emissions without government interference. You look at socialist governments like China that are trying to do it from the top down. It's going the opposite direction. The carbon emissions are increasing, not decreasing. When we try and do this stuff from the government level, it has a reverse impact. And as like you said, in Europe, they're facing those, they may be getting some benefit on the reduction, but it's not nearly what we're doing in a free market society. It doesn't come close to the savings that are benefiting the people in our country versus Europe. Anywhere this stuff is tried from the top down, it fails. And it's reminiscent of the old Soviet Socialist Republics with their five-year plans. We keep trying to do this from the government level when industry has been doing a much better job. Up in my area especially, we've got very nice clean streams and everything. Now, as it comes to the settled science, my sister-in-law likes to joke about my light holiday reading. This climate change reconsidered, it's one volume of a three-volume set. It's basically executive summaries with references to science that refutes the man-made portion of global warming, refutes a lot of the information that is being used to try and enforce this top-down dictatorial style of control over good businesses like the ones you represent that are trying to do the right thing and are making strides to giving us a good place to live like we have up in my area, and yet people try to penalize them in the name of having power concentrated at the government level. And the scientists that have been promoting global warming on a man-made global warming are often the ones that are benefiting through studies that are funded by the government to promote and produce these kinds of things. It happened in Britain, and that actually came out in a very scandalous way over there. It's frustrating to hear people attacking those who are trying to do a good job, who live in the communities, and are trying to make their lives better for those communities. So this is, like I said, this gets frustrating for me. And when it's personally taken and attacks at businesses that my constituents work for, I have a severe problem with it. I want to thank you for the report, and I want to thank you for the information.
Thank you. I appreciate it.